Welcome to Whatever Happened to Pizza at McDonald's, the podcast where I ask the question, whatever happened to the pizza at McDonald's? I'm your host, Brian Thompson. Recently, I visited my local public library so that I might read the World Book Encyclopedia entry for McDonald's pizza. There was no such entry. But while conducting my investigation, the weight of my labors began to strain my spirits. I decided it was time to engage in what the Hospice for Dying Rodents, where I volunteer, calls self-care. So I went to the library's computerized card catalog and searched for some escapist fare to enjoy that evening at home. Naturally, my mind settled on the 1988 fantasy epic Willow. Directed by Cinderella Man's Ron Howard, with a story by George Lucas, the visionary mind behind the Young Indiana Jones Chronicles and Radioland Murders, Willow is the tale of a short amateur magician who sets out on a quest to save a hairy baby from the evil infant-killing queen Bavmorda, a name which translates to bad abortionist. Along the way, Willow teams up with a swashbuckling swordsman, played by Mark Twain himself, Val Kilmer, and two even shorter gentlemen, played by stand-up comedians, one of whom is now the host of the hit podcast Kevin Pollak's podcast. I resolved to spend my evening watching Willow for two reasons. One, I thought it might be therapeutic to take my mind off my grueling investigation of McDonald's pizza and allow myself to be transported to a magical realm where people can be any height. Two, I found some parallels between myself and Willow. Like him, I too have been thrust into a dangerous yet thrilling world of intrigue simply because I set about to do the right thing. Also, neither one of us is tall. When I saw via the library's computerized card catalog that, indeed, the DVD of Willow was available for loan, I was elated. But when I reached the shelf where Willow should have been located, elation transformed into deflation. The public library's copy of Willow was missing. I checked out another fantasy film that happened to be in the W's. Entitled Warriors of Virtue, it concerns a young man who jumps into a sewer and is transported to a land where kangaroos know karate. But if I'm being honest, I could not pay attention. My mind kept returning to the missing Willow DVD. Before I left the library, I did my due diligence by tasking the reference librarian with scouring the premises. Perhaps I thought the DVD had simply been misshelved. Perhaps, by way of example, placed in the section for Japanese animated films about wet people. But, after 2 hours of searching, the trained librarian came up empty-handed. One has to wonder, what kind of criminal would steal the library's copy of Willow? Who would place his or her selfish greed above the needs of those of us who desperately crave respite from the toils of our daily lives? Who knows what other put-upon souls have had their entertainment plans dashed by this sticky-fingered bandit? I had to find out.
Referenced, may I help you?
Hello, my name is Brian Thompson, and I recently visited the library looking for a copy of the movie Willow on DVD, and it was discovered to be missing.
Okay.
And I was wondering if you ever filed a police report on the matter?
I don't believe that's something we would do.
Why is that?
When it's marked missing, then we actually look into finding it first. So, and if it's missing, we wouldn't have any idea who took it, so there's not really a police report to be filed.
I believe it may be a high-value item.
Well, if you'd like, I can go back and check the shelf to see if it is here. I'm showing that there are two other copies of it in the system.
Well, I did have a librarian help me when I was there. I don't know if it was you, but we did look on the various shelves and could not find the copy.
Okay. All right.
Have you checked the security camera records?
I don't know if they have or not, but oftentimes if it's just gone missing, we then search for it. It could be that someone picked it up and put it in a different place. place where it shouldn't go, so we give it a little while to maybe find its way back to where it belongs.
Okay, so you're not interested in conducting a criminal investigation?
I don't know what type of criminal investigation we would be running.
Theft?
On it.
I am willing to give a sworn testimony if that's necessary.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, you're welcome.
Goodbye. Once again, I'm on my own. Today's episode of Whatever Happened to Pizza at McDonald's is brought to you by Hunt a Killer. Do you think you will be murdered? Are these thoughts fun? Subscribe to Hunt a Killer, and every month you will be sent items to remind you that you might be murdered. Hunt a Killer. Have fun while you can. Do you know what happened to pizza at McDonald's? Do you remember it? Did you steal a DVD of Willow from my local public library? Please send all correspondence to pizza@mcdonalds@gmail.com, to our Twitter page @pizzaatmcd's, or through Facebook @facebook.com/pizzaatmcd's. Subscribe to us on iTunes, and if you like the show, consider leaving a review. And to provide financial support, visit patreon.com/pizzaatmcd's. I'm Brian Thompson.